Morning children, in continuation with the chapter problem of deficient demand and excess demand, where in my previous session I have explained you the problem of deficient demand. So today in this session I am going to explain you the problem of excess demand. Well children, excess demand means excess of AD. Demand is said to be excess when it is more than what is required for fuller utilization of resources, where we say that AD is greater than AS. Now, how can we measure this excess demand? There is a diagram, if you see on your screen, where on the x-axis is income, that is GDP, and on the y-axis is AD, that is aggregate demand. Now, there ADF line is showing the required level of AD for full employment in the economy, whereas ADP line shows planned AD, which is higher than the full employment. And if you see a vertical line, that is the vertical difference between ADP and ADF is EF. And children, this EF is the excess demand. That means this is the economy where the planned AD is much higher than the ADF. That means it is the planned AD is much higher than the fuller utilization of the resources. Now, why it happens? Why it is happening that in an economy that AD is more than AS? Now, there are number of the causes. If we go with these causes, first of all, let's see, in two sector closed economy, the very first reason for this higher AD is increase in private consumption expenditure, which means that the people in this economy have increased their expenditure. They are doing more of the expenditure. They are generating more of the demand. Maybe because if we talk about a country like India, here the people are more interested in spending than in saving. Or let's say the poor, they try to spend more to live like the rich. Then the second reason is increase in investment expenditure, which may occur due to, let's say, bullish business expectation, which means that the producer are expecting that in the future they will be getting a good return if they invest more. So that is the another reason more the demand is generated. Now if you talk about an open economy, in an open economy, the very first reason for the increase in demand is increase in government expenditure. That means government is expending or doing more of the expenditure by fulfilling the commitments for the development as well as welfare projects. The second is increase in export. That means due to the low domestic prices in relation to the international prices. That means people are getting a good price if they are selling their products in the international market. So they are generating more of the AD. Then decrease in import. The imports are decreased due to high international prices as compared to the domestic price. So more of the AD is generated. Or let's say a cut in tax rates, which is leaving a very high disposable income with the people. That means government have reduced the taxes and due to which the people have more income in their hand. And that is why they are generating more of the AD. Now when this happens, then what are the consequences of this excess AD? Let's see. The very first consequences, if we talk about this AD, is inflationary gap. Now, when we talk about inflationary gap, the word itself is telling you it means that somewhere when the prices, they rise in the market beyond expectation. Now, over here, if you see, there's a diagram showing an inflationary gap where on the x-axis you have income and output, that is GDP, on the y you have aggregate demand, and a vertical line between ADF and ADP, where ADF is full utilization of resources, ADP is planned, and the point between ADP and ADF is EF, which is an inflationary gap. Now this inflationary gap equals to or leads to an excess demand, which is EF. Now, what are the reasons behind this? So, children, inflationary gap causes, excess demand causes an inflationary gap in the economy. And it is a situation where excess demand or the level of output does not rise. In fact, Let's say it cannot rise because resources are fully utilized when technology is constant. Now, over here, what happens? This excess demand, they generates pressure on the present resources. Now, accordingly, what happens? The cost of production. Let's say the production cannot increase. The reason? Because resources are already fully utilized. So the only thing what happens is cost of production, it tends to rise, means prices, they rise. When the general price level, they rise in economy, then a situation of inflationary gap is experienced in the economy. And that is why we say that excess AD leads to pressure of demand on existing resources, which leads to rise in cost of production, which then again leads to rise in general price level and then to output level, which remains constant because resources are already fully utilized. Now, the second consequence of this excess AD is static GDP. Static GDP means, children, that the GDP will not rise if the price of the products rises in the market. The reason, even when the level of AD is higher than its employment, the level of GDP does not rise. It will remain static, means stagnant. It is a situation when higher demands fail to generate higher GDP in the economy. And children, this is because resources are already fully employed. There is no excess capacity in the economy. If you see, there is a diagram where on the x-axis again you have income, and that is GDP. On the y you have an aggregate demand. And if you see in this diagram, you will find that GDP, that is equals to OL, right? Now this OL is when AD is at full employment, then also it is OL only. Can you see in the diagram? When there is an ADF, then GDP is still OL. And when, let's say, the line is ADP, then again GDP equals to OL even when AD is higher than full employment level. That means, if you see, then point E and the point F, that is point E on ADP and point F on ADF, they both are at the OL. That means that if there is a situation of full employment or if there is a situation of a planned employment, the GDP remains constant. It is not increasing. Now, when we say GDP remains constant, the reason, you know, because resources are fully and efficiently utilized. There is no excess capacity in the economy. And here GDP remains constant. Over here, we are referring to a real GDP, not the nominal. Now, nominal GDP, when we talk about this nominal GDP, when the price increases at the current level, that means that the excess demand leads to a rise in general price level, implying that GDP at current price will rise. Thus, in a situation of excess demand, then the quantity of goods and services produced in the economy remains constant, though the market level of goods and services tends to rise. Then the next consequence of the excess demand is wage, that is excess demand and wage price spiral. Now, this excess demand leads to wage price spiral in the economy, means a situation, it's like a vicious circle which has been formed, where it's a situation where wages catch price and price catches wages. Now, it happens how? Now, due to the excess demand, children, there is pressure on the demand of the existing resources. So, due to which the cost of production rises. So, in cost of production, the wages rise. As you rise the wage, what will happen? The price of the product will rise. When the price will rise, then the cost of living rise. And when cost of living rises, then again wages rise. So, like this, wages catches price and price catches wages. And the last consequence is loss of profit. That is, under this, you know, like deficient demand, excess demand also cause loss of profit. Profit is lost because the producers are not able to raise their supplies. In other words, there is a loss of profit due to unfulfilled demand in the economy. And excess demand is actually forms a vicious circle. How? You know, it generates an inflationary spiral. Because devoid of rise in GDP, the excess AD generates pressure on the existing resources, and accordingly what happens? The cost of production, it rises. and the cost of production rises, then the economy is caught in a wage price spiral, a challenge to stability in the economy. Means it is the economy where the demand is more and the producer is not in a position to fulfill that demand because he has already used all the resources which were available in the economy and has produced. Now he is not in a situation to produce more. So in such a situation, he is in a state of loss because he is not able to fulfill the existing demand. And that is how we say that excess demand also leads to a number of problems. Thank you. Good morning.